All right. So keep that thing in mind. I again repeat, color of first ring gives us first digit of resistance. Color of second ring gives us second digit. And the color of third ring gives us the multiplier. And color of fourth ring. Fourth ring is always either golden, silver, or it is having no color. Then we can tell the tolerance, right? We can tell the tolerance ki within what extent this value is correct. Within what error limit this value is correct that we are indicating. So right now in the above example, the resistance is 26 into 10 raised to the power 5 ohm without tolerance. This is the value corresponding to colors indicated right now. So first ring, that is of red color. Second is blue. Third is green. Accordingly, I have written the resistances. So BB Roy, Great Britain, very good wife. From here, you can learn this. Then in order, you can write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Okay. So first one is black. Last one is white. Or second last is mixture of those two. That is gray. And in between, you have complete Vibgyor, and below black, there is brown color. Lighter than black, there is brown color. So I was talking about tolerance. So let us write tolerance now. If the fourth ring is golden, then the tolerance will be plus minus 5%. If it is silver, then the tolerance is plus minus 10%. And if the ring is not golden or silver, no color, then it will be plus minus 20%. So this would be the tolerance. All right, this would be the tolerance. Is that clear? So in above case, I have taken it to be of golden color. Ye maine isko golden color ka liya. Theek hai? Then I would write the value is 26 into 10 raised to power 5 plus minus 5%. So this is the value of resistance shown by current resistor. So you can calculate accordingly 5% of 26 into 10 raised to power 5. So plus minus that value, you can calculate. Okay. So plus minus this. So 26 into 10 raised to power 5 plus minus 130,000. That will be your current resistance. It's very large value of resistance, but we are also indicating the uncertainty. So this can be the possible error. Chaliye, likhiye question aap. On this basis, there can be a reverse way also of asking the questions. Likhiye question. The resistance of a carbon resistor is 47 into 10 raised to power 3 ohm. Predict the sequence of colors. Resistance of a carbon resistor is 47 into 10 raised to power 3 ohm. Predict the sequence of colors. Yes, who will tell me the sequence of colors? Yes, what would be the sequence of colors? Yes, students?
Ma'am, yellow pehle. Fir violet.
Yes.
Fir orange.
Yes, yellow, violet, orange. So according to the digits given, 4 corresponds to yellow, 7 corresponds to violet, and 3 orange. So it will be yellow, violet, and orange. So this way, questions may be there. So this is color code of carbon resistors. And name the device that is used to measure this resistance of a carbon resistor. Note down, that is a multimeter. We have in the lab both types of multimeters, simple multimeter and digital multimeter, both we are having. And we do this activity also in the lab. Using multimeter, we always find the resistance of this carbon resistor. Multi means many things we can do with this meter. For example, ammeter can measure only the current, voltmeter can only measure the potential difference, but multimeter is a device that can measure current also, voltage also, resistance also. So all in one, right? So that's why it is called multimeter, multitasking, right? Okay, so let us continue with the next topic of this unit, Meissner effect. Meissner effect. This effect is similar to electrostatic screening or shielding. We did electrostatic screening. Wo kya tha? Ki inside a conductor, the electric field is always zero. So we remain protected from external unwanted electric field. That was electrostatic shielding. Meissner effect is indirectly magnetostatic screening. That suppose we have a conductor. It is cooled to a temperature below its critical temperature. And then it is kept in the path of magnetic lines of force. Then magnetic lines won't pass through it. Magnetic lines won't pass through it, indicating zero magnetic field inside. This is called Meissner effect. Okay, so suppose there is a conductor and it is cooled to a temperature below its critical temperature. So what will happen? No magnetic lines would prefer to pass through this material. So that means magnetic field inside this conductor would be zero, and this is called magnetostatic screening or Meissner effect. Theek hai, likhiye iski definition, write down what is Meissner effect. When a conductor is cooled to a temperature below its critical temperature. When a conductor is cooled to a temperature below its critical temperature and placed in uniform magnetic field. Then no magnetic lines prefer to pass through it. This effect, this phenomenon is called Meissner effect. Okay. So this is magnetostatic, you can call it magnetostatic screening or shielding also. Okay, chaliye next karte hain, combination of resistances in series and parallel that you already are aware of, but it's necessary to do because we are to do a number of numericals also based on this combination of resistances. So first of all, let us define what is equivalent resistance. Equivalent resistance kya hota hai? Kaun bataye? 10th mein padha hua hai aapne. What do you mean by equivalent resistance? It is a single resistance that would produce the same effect as is produced by a number of resistances together. Okay, equivalent resistance is the single resistance that would produce the same effect as is produced by a number of resistances together. Okay, So we are taking two resistors, R1 and R2 here. Connected to a cell or a battery. Okay. Then current will start flowing from positive to negative, and you can see same current is flowing through both the resistors. So current remains same in series combination. Which physical quantity remains same? You know, current remains same in series combination of resistances. Right. Now, if battery voltage is V, then potential differences across the two resistances will be different. V1 and V2 are suppose the potential differences across the two resistors, then total potential difference will be the sum of individual ones. So V is equal to IRS. V1 we can write IR1. V2 is IR2. Already you are familiar with this. So this is very simple treatment. Current to same hai, but voltage will be the sum of both the voltages. So current gets cancelled on both sides and we are left with this formula for series combination of resistances. So R is equal to R1 plus R2. So any number of resistances we can have, we are simply going to add them up. And this is the maximum possible resistance we can have. Out of given number of resistances, if we want to obtain maximum resistance or minimum current, we must connect those resistances in series combination. ठीक है, तो हमें उनको series में connect करना पड़ेगा. I hope this is clear to you. Then parallel combination भी just a revision ही है, वो भी आपको पता ही है, parallel का already you are aware of. So parallel combination heading दे दीजिए next. Parallel combination. So we are now having two resistances R1 and R2 in parallel, connected in parallel to each other, to a battery and a key. So you can easily see if I is the total current flowing, then it will get divided into two parts. Because there are two branches, accordingly it will divide into two parts and then total current I will be coming out also. If resistance R1 is more, I1 will be less and vice versa. So current through the two branches depends upon the resistance that is connected in that branch. Okay, so you can easily see here that if battery potential is V, potential differences difference across both the resistances will be same here. So which physical quantity remains same in parallel combination, that is potential difference remains the same. Okay, so what we can write, current is dividing up into two parts, so we can write I is equal to I1 plus I2. So using Ohm's formula, V is equal to IR, we can write I is equal to V upon R. So accordingly, I can be written as V over RP, I1 can be written as V over R1, I2 can be written as V over R2. So voltages get cancelled on both the sides and we are left with 1 over RP is 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. So in parallel, we add the reciprocals of individual resistances to get the reciprocal of equivalent resistance. So surely series resistance is greater than parallel resistance. So if we want to obtain maximum current through a given number of resistors, we must connect them in parallel because this combination will give us minimum resistance or maximum current. Okay, so this is about parallel combination. And further, if we want to find current through different branches, you know, potential difference across the two resistors, that will be the same. So we can write I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2. You can write this, no problem. Okay. I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2. So I is equal to I1 plus I2 also. Okay, so let us put one of the resistances here, say I2, we can put I1 R1 over R2. So put this I2 here, we'll get I is equal to I1 plus I1 R1 over R2. Take out I1 common, I1 nikal rahe hain bahar, theek hai? Take out I1 common. So I1 is 1 plus R1 over R2 equal to I. So you can easily see by taking LCM, I1 is R2 over R1 plus R2 into I1. So this is another formula of parallel combination. If we want to find current through one branch, then it will be equal to resistance through the other branch over total resistance into total current. Okay, this is how you can write. Dekhiye. So ek shortcut formula bhi aap use kar sakte. So I1, current through one branch, is resistance through other branch over total resistance into total current. So aap directly isko apply kar sakte. ठीक है, by using such a formula you can directly and similarly करके आप I2 भी लिख सकते हो. वन का टू कर दो, टू का वन कर दो. So similarly you can write I2 as well. I2 will be R1 over R1 plus R2 into I2 into I1. Okay, so this is how you can find current through different branches in parallel combination. So this will give us current through different branches in parallel combination. Is that clear? So tomorrow we will be discussing some numericals on parallel combination. Then I'll be giving one assignment to you, right? Today let's do the next topic, combination of cells. अब cells का भी combination कर लेते हैं, फिर numericals करेंगे resistances के, ठीक है? So followed by so many numericals and assignment. चलिए, next is if we are having a cell, then what is the terminology related to that cell? And we'll be discussing then the combination of cells also, same way in series, parallel and mixed grouping, right? So first of all, there are some certain things related to a cell. Certain definitions are there. Let us define EMF, terminal potential difference, and internal resistance of a cell. Terminal potential difference and internal resistance. These are three, you can say, characteristics. Internal resistance of a cell. EMF is denoted by symbol capital E. Terminal potential difference is simple potential difference V. And internal resistance is denoted by symbol small r. ठीक है, so these are three main things related to a cell. So let us define what is the difference between EMF and terminal potential difference, जो आपको almost एक layman को same ही लगता है. ठीक है, तो चलिए, suppose we have connected a cell and there is a bulb connected in the circuit and there is a key. Okay. Now, when the cell is in open circuit, right, bulb does not glow, bulb glow nahi karega, and no current would be flowing, no potential drop would be there. Kyunki ye jo bulb hai, iska kuch resistance hai. This we have connected in place of resistance. Bulb will have certain resistance. How can you calculate? You know the power of bulb, suppose it's of 100 watt. Then using P is equal to V square upon R, you can find its own fixed resistance. ठीक है, तो उसका resistance ignorable नहीं होता, it's having quite appreciable amount of resistance. तो जब हमने key press ही नहीं की है, इसको off position में रखा है, then no current would be flowing through the cell. No current is being drawn by the cell. ठीक है, so then this potential difference across the terminals of the cell will be maximum and it will be called EMF of the cell. So likhiye, what is EMF? Basically it is potential difference only between the terminals of the cell also, but in an open circuit. When no current is being drawn by the cell, then the potential difference, which is maximum, that is called EMF of the cell. Likhiye definition. EMF is potential difference. EMF is potential difference between the terminals of a cell EMF is the potential difference between the terminals of a cell in an open circuit. In an open circuit, that is when, वो भी लिख दो साथ में, that is when no current is being drawn from the cell. That is when no current is being drawn from the cell. And do you know what is the full form of EMF? Pata hai kisi ko? What is the full form of EMF? Anyone knows?
Electromotive force.
Yes, it is electromotive force, but this word is misnomer here. It is electromotive force, but it is not a force we have seen. It's potential difference. So this word force is a misnomer here. Okay, it is not a force actually. It is potential difference only. Right? So basically, hoga kya ye work done per unit charge hoga. Like we have potential difference. So the unit of EMF is also volt. ठीक है, EMF का unit भी 1 volt ही होगा, right? और for example, what is the EMF of a dry cell that you use at home in your remotes, remote controls में जो आप dry cell use करते हो, उसकी EMF कितनी होती है? Did you notice? 1.5 volt. Okay, that's why you connect 2 cells in series and then you give total potential difference of 3 volt. Okay, so Leclanché cell is the previous form of dry cell. We'll be using in the lab also. It is also, that's why having an EMF of 1.5 volt. And Daniell cell. केमिस्ट्री में पढ़ा होगा आपने, डेनियल सेल कॉपर वेसल वाला जो होता है जिसमें कॉपर सल्फेट होता है, जिंक रॉड होती है, ठीक है, पोरस पॉट होता है. तो डेनियल सेल दैट इज हैविंग लेसर ईएमएफ 1.1 वोल्ट. ठीक है, जो लिथियम बैटरीज होती हैं दैट आर यूज्ड इन मोबाइल्स एटसेट्रा, दे आर हैविंग वेरी लार्ज ईएमएफ. ठीक है, 3 to 6 वोल्ट के बीच में उनकी ईएमएफ लाई करती है. राइट, ये जो लिथियम सेल्स है, इवन बटन सेल्स तो उनकी ईएमएफ काफी लार्ज होती है. अदरवाइज ये जो प्राइमरी सेल्स हैं, ड्राई सेल, लेक्लेंचे सेल, डेनियल सेल, देयर ईएमएफ रेंजेस इन दिस रेंज ओनली 1.5 वोल्ट लाइक दैट. ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट टर्म इज टर्मिनल पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस. आफ्टर दिस नेक्स्ट टर्म इज टर्मिनल पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस. Terminal potential difference. Suppose now we close the circuit. Okay, now we close the circuit. What will happen? Current will start flowing through this bulb and the current will be drawn from the cell. यहां पे आप ये बना लीजिए key का symbol proper, वो open थी, अब ये key हमने close कर दी. So what will happen? Current will start flowing now through the bulb and now the bulb will start glowing. This circuit will be closed circuit and now when the current is being drawn from the cell, now the potential difference when the cell is in use, that is called terminal potential difference, or simply we call it potential difference also. So when we speak potential difference, that means we are speaking about terminal potential difference only. ठीक है, तो लिख लीजिए definition. Terminal potential difference की, it is the potential difference between the terminals of a cell. It is the potential difference between the terminals of a cell in a closed circuit. In a closed circuit, that is when, in a closed circuit, that is when current is being drawn from the cell. That is when cell is in use. That is when current is being drawn from the cell. So that is called terminal potential difference. तो यहाँ पे हम mention भी कर देते, ये देखिए यहाँ पे इस केस में potential difference यहाँ पे terminal potential difference है, and in the previous case when the cell was not in use, then this potential difference is called EMF E. Okay, so this is how they are different. Is this concept clear to you? Then third term is internal resistance of the cell. You know how does a cell work? there are two electrodes, cathode, anode, and then there is an electrolyte, which is a conducting solution. So when electricity is passed, then what happens? The ions start moving. So what is internal resistance of a cell? It is the obstruction offered to the flow of current by the ions of the electrolyte. तो जो इलेक्ट्रोलाइट के आयंस हैं वो जितनी ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफर कर रहे हैं उसको हम इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस कहेंगे. बैटरी का, सेल का अपना इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस कितना है. तो लिखिए इसकी डेफिनेशन. द ऑपोजिशन ऑफर्ड टू द फ्लो ऑफ करंट बाय द इलेक्ट्रोलाइट ऑफ अ सेल that is called internal resistance small r of a cell. That is called internal resistance of a cell, and since it is resistance, its unit will be ohm. Iska unit kya hoga? Ohm hi ohm. Now what are the factors on which internal resistance depends? Factors bhi likh lijiye. It will depend upon nature of electrolyte. Factors affecting internal resistance of a cell, it depends upon nature of electrolyte. Obviously us pe depend karega. Koi electrolyte zyada conducting hoga uska internal resistance small hoga, kisi ka large hoga, like that. Second factor is larger the separation between the electrodes, more is internal resistance. So it always also depends upon the separation between electrodes. More is the separation, more will be the internal resistance. So separation between electrodes. Separation. Then third is the internal resistance of a freshly prepared cell is less. अगर cell long use में हो, काफी देर बाद आप use करो, उसका internal resistance high हो चुका होता है. तो when we will be doing the experiments of potentiometer, we'll be using two cells in that experiment. और हम उसमें zinc rod जो है बाहर निकाल के रखते हैं, हम उसको अंदर डाले नहीं रखते, क्योंकि अगर zinc rod डाल देंगे cell would be complete and reactions will be continuing and the cell will be used. And it will not be freshly prepared cell, and we might not get correct readings after a long time. So that's why हम zinc rod को बाहर निकाल के रखते हैं कि वो use में ना हो, वो cell fresh ही रहे, ठीक है? तो लिख लीजिए, resistance of freshly prepared cell is less. So as it is used, its internal resistance increases. तो ये point लिख सकते हो, freshly prepared cell. Internal resistance of a freshly prepared cell is less and used cell is more. Next, it is inversely proportional to area of electrodes dipped in the electrolyte. जो electrodes हमने रखे हुए हैं उनके area के inversely proportional. So area of the plates, electrode plates, area of electrode प्लेट्स के ऊपर भी डिपेंड करता है, इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल. मोर इज द एरिया, लेसर विल बी द इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस, एंड वाइस वर्सा. एंड लास्ट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर इज टेम्परेचर. टेम्परेचर, इसका आइडिया आपको भी होगा. इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू स्टार्ट कार इंजन ऑन अ चिली डे एज कंपेयर टू दैट ऑन अ समर डे. आपका जो विंटर्स होती हैं उसमें आपने देखा होगा व्हीकल्स को लोग किक्स मारते हैं, उसको वार्म अप करने की कोशिश करते हैं, क्योंकि एट लो टेम्परेचर इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस बिकम्स हाई. ठीक है, सो इट इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल. व्हेन द टेम्परेचर इज लेस, इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस इज हाई, एंड वाइस वर्सा. और समर्स में टेम्परेचर ज्यादा होने की वजह से इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस कम होता है, तो आपका व्हीकल इमिजिएटली स्टार्ट हो जाता है, तो इसका इंजन एकदम से स्टार्ट हो जाता है. तो दिस इज ऑल्सो कंसेप्चुअल क्वेश्चन. That why does it take longer to start a car engine on a chilly day as compared to that on a summer day, hot day? So these are the factors on which internal resistance of a cell depends. ठीक है, कल हम इन तीनों में relation करेंगे, EMF, terminal potential difference, and internal resistance of cell में relation करेंगे. you try to write differences between EMF and terminal potential difference. Because you know what is the distribution of board 20, 60, 20. So 20% paper is below for below average students also. तो उसमें कई बार चांसेस होते हैं कि ऐसे क्वेश्चंस आ जाएं. तो ज्यादा इजी क्वेश्चन है वो भी इंटेलिजेंट बच्चों को कई बार नहीं आते हैं, है ना. बट वी आर टू कीप आवरसेल्व्स रेडी फॉर एवरीथिंग. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, इज दैट क्लियर? कोई डाउट पूछना है तो पूछ सकते हो आप.